Hey guys, Sportrot here. So I thought I'll make a quick tutorial video about the concept of how to, as artists, and this also applies to photographers or film directors, to influence and direct viewers' attention. It often relates to this concept called aerial perspective. But what I really want to focus on here is what controls and makes some elements recede and what makes some advance or come forward. Now, some of you might already have a good idea of what I'm going to talk about, and some may not be familiar with this. Now, when I talk about making a part of a picture recede or advance, it is not technically about distance, although correlation-wise, the closer elements tends to capture most of our attention and come forward, and things that are further away tends to recede, but this is not always the case. So when I'm talking about recede and advance, I'm talking about where they are in the viewer's attention, whether they are in that sense in focus or in the background of their mind. Now let me get a big misconception out of the way, because as I hope we all know, like, correlation is not causation. So some people tend to think, or worse yet, they might have been taught that certain colors tends to come forward and some colors tends to recede or fade in the background. Or that warm colors like red is likely to advance and cool colors like green or blue tends to recede. And this is a misconception, because although colors like red does more likely to get our attention because the way they are often used, what makes something grab your attention or fade into background fundamentally has little to do with color. It is really two things. Well, actually, if I think about it, it's actually, I'll make it even simpler. It's really just one thing, which is contrast. You see, strong contrast advances and comes forward and captures a viewer's attention. Again, I'll reiterate that when I say advance, I mean it grabs their attention. It's not about distance. So brightest white tends to come forward, you know, like a reflection on something or a reflection in somebody's eyes. Unless the picture is full of white, right? Then the contrast is gone. But brightest white do tend to more likely to come forward, since white contrasts easily and with its surroundings. By the same token, deepest dark tends to advance, probability-wise. Sharp edges, strong details, and focused stuff, they tend to come forward. Unless, of course, the sharp edge is made from two very similar colors. In that case, there is really not much contrast, so it's not even fundamentally about the sharpness of anything. It comes back down to contrast. It just so happens that 90% of times, sharp edges and colors like red and detailed stuff have high contrast, so they advance. Now, you can achieve visual contrast by playing around with mainly three different properties: a difference in color, value, and focus, or some kind of combination. Let's take a look at a very famous example, Van Gogh's Starry Night. I'm not even going to try to pronounce his name properly in Dutch, because I know that's technically not how you say his last name. So you can see that the sharpness is fairly even, the same across the drawing. But the furthest objects, the stars, the moon, the heavenly bodies, they tend to immediately grab and enter our attention, right? While the closer stuff, like the houses and the farm and so on, tend kind of fade into background. Now, an interesting thing is that this is actually one of the very first few famous paintings where the subject of the painting that we viewers focus on as artists intended is what we usually think of as the background, the night sky. And we can see how this is accomplished, which is contrast in color. Blue and yellow exist opposite to each other on the color wheel, which that means that they have the highest contrast with each other, and basically, you can't make blue appear more blue or vibrant than to place it next to yellow, and vice versa. Also, of course, the tree advances due to its contrast with its surroundings. So let me play around with some examples in Photoshop, as well as showing you eventually a drawing that I have done on YouTube recently that used this principle pretty strongly. Now, I'm going to mainly focus on using sharpness and blur to increase and decrease contrast, which affects where your attention immediately goes to, because it is one of the most common and effective techniques, and one which we're all pretty familiar with. Now this is a fairly normal street view picture. As you can see that everything's in focus right now. Everything is sharp. And what immediately grabs most people's attention is probably, like the yellow cab or the yellow trees, right? Because they have the greatest difference with their surroundings in terms of color. And now let's say we want the viewers to focus on something else. Now I'm not going to manipulate the colors that much because I cannot produce a better example than what I have just presented, the Starry Night. I can play around with the value, but the most effective property to manipulate is sharpness. So let us do that and change users' focus. Now let's make something we wouldn't normally notice immediately stand out. I'll just pick this lady here. Even though there are other people in the picture, somewhat closer, let's see if we can put our focus on her, right? Now there are easier ways to do this, but I'll just use this tool called Field Blur. And I'll blur out everything else except, where she is. And I don't need the blur to be too strong. Obviously, if it's really strong, it would work very well, but a tiny bit would do the trick. And now you see how she becomes the center of focus. I can make the effect even stronger by changing the tone value a little bit and increase that, increase contrast that way. And you see now that we can't help but looking at this area. Now let's quickly do a couple more examples with a different picture. Here we have a Porsche 911, beautiful car, but let's make the background mountains and the first landscapes stand out. So I'm just going to isolate that part, increase the tone contrast, and decrease the color saturation for everything else a little, and add some blur. And as you can see, you can feel the effect. Some of you car lovers will probably still focus on the car, but you get the idea. The mountain became a lot more prominent. Now let's do one more effect and make this a typical effect you see with high-end cameras that has distance focus control, right? So let's say we want to focus on the front left headlight of the car. I'm just going to use Field Blur again and basically blur stuff that distance-wise is further away. And I'll make this more accurate by applying more or less blur based on the distance, like the distance of them from the headlight. And as you can see the result, it's a pretty nice trick. You can make a photo look more professional than it is, but you can see how this works. So yeah, I mentioned I did an art piece that used this technique, and here it is. And of course, I don't need to explain what I did, what I wanted you to focus on, or how it is done at this point. So if you didn't pay attention to anything, just remember this one line, which is contrast controls focus. Thank you, and I hope this has been helpful, especially my patrons on Patreon that make videos like this possible. I plan to make more little tips like this and more in-depth stuff, and commentary videos and PSDs for my digital art, but due to time, most of them is going to be exclusively available for my patrons. So please consider getting exclusive content by joining my Patreon club. It requires very little. You will get all those information while supporting my work. You can check out the page for some detailed information. And if you subscribe to me here on YouTube, make sure you turn on notification. Thanks guys, until next time, cheers!